Joined by Matt Rooney. Matt Rooney is an attorney. He's a friend of the show, and he is the editor of the Save Jersey blog. Matt, good morning. Thanks for calling into New Jersey 101.5.
So thanks for having me.
Yeah, so Matt, what do you make of it? Let's break this down. Now, I introduced you by saying you've been very critical of the governor in the past. And, you know, I've seen you kind of go on both sides, and you just objectively analyze what's in front of you. Take a crack at this one. I think this veto override is ridiculous because the legislation itself was just political cover to give these guys talking points, to act like they're doing something when in reality, nothing. But that and then the other side, does this hurt Christie?
Well, first of all, I think you make a really good point here, Bill. Just because there may or may not be a political motivation for something doesn't change the substance of the bill. So in this case, we all know Chris Christie's running for president. But that doesn't mean that that makes the bill more or less good. And in this case, I would argue that this is an extremely defective bill. What New Jerseyans, less of them may know, because not everybody's a political nerd like you or I, Bill, so they follow this stuff blow by blow.
I take that as a compliment.
Yeah, and I do too, and you should. But Steve Sweeney's running for governor. So he has every interest in the world to try to embarrass Chris Christie over a gun issue, because you and I know that for certain elements of the far left Democrat base, attacking gun owners, law-abiding gun owners, is like catnip. This is what these people live for. But this bill does not get the job done. I want somebody to explain it to me, okay? Steve Sweeney is trying to make a link between people that are going and applying for a gun permit and the actual expungement. I want him to cite for me the case where somebody went and got a medical expungement, they subsequently went and got a gun permit, and then they shot up a school or a workplace or a hospital.
Yes,
I'm not
Matt.
Sure he can find one.
No, Matt, you know what? I said that earlier, that where is the tie-in to actual crime? And my understanding is that this is a very extensive process already for someone to go through and try to have their medical and mental health records expunged in a certain way that would qualify them for other jobs. And 2 points. One, this does not apply now to anybody who's not applying for a gun permit. So guess what? What about the ambulance drivers? What about the security guard? What about the dental hygienist? I mean, there are plenty of people that have the proximity to other people that could cause harm. Why aren't we worried about everybody if we're worried about this one sliver? And then the other point is, I don't even understand why they're dismissing the process that a judge would have to make a decision. Do we now have no confidence in the process at all? I mean, I didn't even realize you could expunge your record like that. I'm not familiar with that whole process, but it sounds extensive to me. Am I wrong?
No, you're not wrong at all. And you just asked the question, why are we concerned about the deeper issue here? Well, you and I are, but Steve Sweeney isn't, because this isn't actually about keeping New Jersey safe. Look, they don't even care about our quality of life here. Forget about gun violence. Can we even afford to live in this state? They've tried to override Chris Christie 50 times.
Yeah.
That's 50 times they could have tried to lower our property taxes, Bill. Yet here we are talking about a bill that doesn't even attack the crime that they allege they're trying to get at. Senator Kaine had another bill that also addressed this expungement issue, but also would have changed the standard for judges to be able to commit somebody to outpatient treatment.
Mm.
Now, we can talk all day about whether we agree with that bill, and it should have gotten a debate, but that's not how it works in the New Jersey Senate.
Right.
Dissenting opinions don't get aired. But guess what? At least that's a problem, okay, that is out there and needs to be addressed. Senator Kaine recognizes that every time we have one of these mass shootings, when they do occur, it's committed by somebody that everybody knew was crazy, but for one reason or another, they slipped the net. So at least that attacks the problem. Why isn't Senator Sweeney interested in having that conversation? Because this is about scoring points. It's about getting elected governor in a Democrat primary.
Yeah, it almost feels like he is maneuvering around Steve Phillip. Like he's carving out his position on the left in case Steve Phillip gets any traction out of Jersey City. I mean, and I think Phillip is going to be a formidable power. I don't know about Murray, the former German ambassador. I don't know. I don't know if he's going to get traction. He's got the money. But to me, if I'm betting this, if you're scoring it, I think Sweeney's got the edge right now. Do you agree?
Oh, he definitely does. He's got a very powerful South Jersey machine behind him.
Yeah.
But it goes back to the overarching point. Why does New Jersey, our pocketbooks, our livelihoods, our safety, have to continue to be subject to these guys' Game of Thrones? They continue to try to one-up each other to get a more powerful seat so they could steer more patronage to each other.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, gun violence continues in our cities that are controlled by Democrat mayors, some of which, like you mentioned, Stephen Fulop, wants to run for governor. It's ridiculous. Enough is enough. They need to focus on
it's a great point.
That actually affects our lives.
They haven't addressed the situation in Newark. We've talked about this, the community guns, the idea that gangs have the guns hidden to get around the potential to get stopped on the street. And, you know, the access to firearms for gangs and criminals. I hear about a shooting. It seems like every couple days someone is in trouble, and it's in a place where you know is a problem, yet we don't have anyone in Trenton addressing law enforcement going into these areas to actually solve the real problem, which is putting families at risk every day in this state. All right, Matt Rooney, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5.